Jeff Bridges there is one of the survivors of a tragic airplane crash in Fearless, and afterwards, Fearless is just what he is, walking across a busy highway there because he's somehow convinced that nothing can kill him. And the movie explores that state of mind, suggesting that in a sense, he's still in shock after the terrible experience, and in another sense, the crash has set him free from his fears and given him a second start in life. His new orientation is almost impossible, however, for his wife to comprehend. Played by Isabella Rossellini, she doesn't understand this husband who has become a haunted stranger.
Every day you have to jump off a roof or stand in front of a train so you can lose your fear? Is that it? What about me? What about Jonah? You're like a crazy person.
I'm not
black
crazy.
Black is white and... I love you. We have lived together for 16 years. They have been great.
Not always.
One person who does understand, played here by Rosie Perez, is another one of the survivors who lived through the crash.
My car's across the street. Let's go for a drive.
No, I can't. The docs told me I can't go nowhere.
You'll be safe. You read the papers? Everybody with me lived.
Remember that Dustin Hoffman movie named Hero a year or two ago? Well, Fearless tells almost the same story, but in a more personal and thoughtful way. After a man becomes a media hero in a plane crash, how does he continue his normal life? Unlike the Hoffman character in Hero, the Bridges character in Fearless has actually survived the crash himself. He's confronted the possibility of his own death, and now in life he has to deal with that. The movie was directed by Peter Weir and written by Rafael Iglesias, and they deserve a lot of credit for exploring the mind of this man who thinks he's been given a pass by fate.
It's an interesting situation. If anybody has had a situation on a plane or something like that or been involved in an accident, and I think a lot more people than we might think have gone through something like that. I had something similar happen to me like that. You do, it does set you free. The question is, how long does it set you free? Now, this movie makes it seem a lot longer than I think it does happen for the average person. I don't think there are that many people that make a complete left-hand turn as while this guy, that this character does. At the same time, it is interesting to me, this phenomenon of, I think it's much more the second case, not that, when he's crossing the street, in a way, there's a real approach of avoidance. In one way, he wants to almost get nailed, Roger. Yeah. It's a strange phenomenon.
He doesn't deserve to live.
Yeah.
Everybody else died, so why is he alive?
He needs, you know what happened? I think what happens here is the cataclysm, or the approaching cataclysm, sets an agenda for his life. It raises the stakes on his life, so he needs to create another one to feel something.
And his wife simply can't identify with that. And what's interesting in the film is that relationship between Bridges and the Rosie Perez character, which kind of tends toward a love story, but really isn't a romance. It's more like they have survivor syndrome. They've been through something that they can't talk about with anyone else, and they can share it.
It's like, battle lives with guys that have, it's a private life and an important life. Her character's interesting because it isn't written as a conventional love story. That's the way you would think the story would go.
I'll tell you, I like Rosie Perez in everything I see her in.